Hi, my name is Kaylee. Welcome to Equivalent Ratios and Double Number Lines. Make sure you've watched the ratios video before jumping into this one. Here we have two rulers of different units. The top ruler is in centimeters, and the bottom ruler is in millimeters. We're going to work together to find the relationship between these two quantities, or the ratio of millimeters per centimeter. Let's explore this in a CK12 simulation. So here we are in the CK12 diagram, and I have my centimeter ruler up here and my millimeter ruler down here. And I can also go over to my tape diagram. But let's start with our rulers. I'm here at zero. I'm going to move over to 1 centimeter. When I do that, I get 10 millimeters are highlighted. Can you think of a ratio phrase that we can describe this relationship as? Like, for every 1 centimeter, there's 10 millimeters. Or there are 10 millimeters per 1 centimeter. Let's try it in our tape diagram. So you have 1 centimeter and 10 millimeters, but what if I move to 2 centimeters? So now I have 2 centimeters, 10, 20 millimeters. If I go back to my ruler, it's going to show the same thing. 2 centimeters per 20 millimeters. And if I go to 3 centimeters, I get 30 millimeters. So do you see the relationship between centimeters and millimeters now? From what we have learned about centimeters and millimeters, we can say for every 1 centimeter, there are 10 millimeters. We can write this ratio as 1 to 10. This tells us that 1 centimeter is equivalent to 10 millimeters. Now, why do you think I use the word equivalent instead of equal? Equal is a very special word in math. And it means that two things are exactly the same way. 1 centimeter is only equal to 1 centimeter. But the word equivalent means that two things are the same in a certain way. 1 centimeter is equivalent to 10 millimeters because they are the same length, but they are in different units and different ways of measuring. We use the 3 horizontal lines to represent the word equivalent, or translates to, in math. And we can talk about ratios being equivalent also. 2 pens per box is equivalent to 8 pens per 4 boxes. We can write their ratios out as 2 pens to 1 box, 2 to 1, is equivalent to 8 pens to 4 boxes, 8 to 4. You can find an equivalent ratio by multiplying or dividing both sides of the ratio by the same number. In this case, we multiply both sides of the 2 to 1 ratio by 4, and we get 8 to 4. But let's take our ideas of equivalent ratios to the double number line. The double number line is very similar to the double rulers we used in the last example, but there's no picture, just 2 horizontal lines. We are comparing how much sugar is in cans of soda. For the double number line, can you determine how much sugar is in 8 fluid ounces of soda? Imagine we draw an imaginary line down from the 8-ounce tick mark, and we find a tick mark for 31 grams of sugar. So we can say, for every 8 fluid ounces of soda, there are 31 grams of sugar. We can write this as a ratio and as a fraction, being careful to choose the right number for the numerator and the first number of our ratio. So they're asking us how much sugar is in 16 fluid ounces. And if we know the ratio of 8 fluid ounces for every 31 grams of sugar, how can we find that for 16 fluid ounces? So what they're asking us really is to find the equivalent ratio here. So we know the ratio of 8 fluid ounces is to 31 grams of sugar, but they want us to find the equivalent one of 16 to how many grams of sugar? Remember, to do this, we need to multiply the top and bottom of our fraction by the same number to get this equivalent fraction. So that looks like we're going to need to multiply this side 2 over 2. So I multiply my numerator and my denominator each by 2 because I know 2 times 8 will give me 16. So I know 2 times 31, I can do that math. That'll be 16. 31 times 2 will be 62. So if I know that this is 62, I can put my number in here. And you've just found the equivalent ratio. So 8 to 31, the equivalent ratio is 16 to 62. So that tells us in a 16 fluid ounce soda, there's 62 grams of sugar. Great job. Awesome work working with double number lines and equivalent ratios. I know it can be a little trickier adding all that math in. But practice what you've learned by completing the activities and playing our games. And remember, have fun and always be clever. Hey, hey.